You're under arrest.
Oh my God. Read the room.
Girls will keep the secret.
You wanna arrest me?
So long, boys, make a noise.
Arrest me.
I just want the egg.
Yeah.
Filipinas Cocina Escape Peru with my friend Dwayne Johnson. Hey man, nice
What's
to see
Bruno?
You.
What's up, Bruno? Hey, it's good to see you, buddy.
Congratulations. I think this is a dream character for you. You got a lot of action as a casual guy. You got exotic location. You could super dress up with a tuxedo. So how fun was?
I mean, truly, Bruno, it was a dream come true. I love this character. I love playing this character. As you said, great action. I got to dress really nicely. I got to have a beautiful dance. I was very sexy with Gone Girl.
Yes.
A lot of comedy in the movie, but also too, what made this role a dream role is that my character was connected to a big surprise. And for audiences, I love surprising people and I mm-hmm. love surprising audiences, and it's hard to do. So I think, I can't wait for people to see the movie.
You know, you are a really hard worker. You are working all the time, different projects developed for you or for others, but I can imagine your desk be like 2,000 projects at the same time. Everyone wants to work with you. So how do you pick the next thing? How is that process?
Sure. That's a great question. Thank you for asking that, Bruno. There's a few prerequisites that I look for. Number one, do I love the project? Do I love what I just read? Do I love what I just heard? Just as important, if not, well, more importantly, will the audience love it? Will the audience, will the people really enjoy this kind of movie in this setting, me in this setting? And if I can check yes on those boxes, then I'm in. Then mm-hmm. I'm in. Because then you set yourself up, to win, or at least you give yourself a great shot of winning, because I can come to work every day loving what I do,
yes,
and loving the people who I'm working with, but then also knowing that I really think the people are going to love this movie or this thing, whatever the thing is.
Like, yes.
I'm ready to deliver to them.
Nolan Booth, the second most wanted art thief in the world. Special Agent John Hartley, FBI.
There's this whole fascination about, you know, treasures, their whereabouts, ancient stuff being missing, and Nazis, somehow they're everywhere. I don't know. Tell me, are you a fan of this type of thing?
Yes. I mean, growing up, I loved movies that were a bit of a treasure hunt. You know, I grew up, I was sort of weaned on the Amblin sensibility and, you know, certainly loving the, you know, Spielberg Zemeckis school of movie making, where, you know, you had these huge adventures. I mean, Back to the Future, obviously, but Indiana Jones was a big one for me. The Last Crusade is a movie I've probably seen at least once a year since it came out.
If we catch her together, I can clear my name.
And I'll help you become the number one thief in the world again.
What's your plan, son of a...
See? Easy peasy.
Tell me about a little bit of pros and cons of shooting around the world.
Well, little secret, we did not shoot around the world. Most of our locations, we were initially supposed to. We were supposed to shoot in Sardinia and Indonesia and Paris and all kinds of places. And then obviously the pandemic hit. So a lot of that was second unit. We shot primarily in Atlanta on sound stages, and you know, all hats off to the crew and Netflix for creating outdoor sets that looked like we were all over the world. It was pretty wild.
Oh, Brian, you didn't see the handcuffs coming. It was a nice touch.
I feel like you guys, throughout the movie, I feel like you guys had a blast shooting. Like, there's a strong chemistry with you and Dwayne. So tell me how much room for improv was during the shooting, and how much does that change the mood on set?
Yeah, I think there's you know, improv is always, it's a big part of what I do, but it's also like implementing it in a way that makes other people feel safe is important to me as well. So you know, cause I've worked with people who improv and it's like, they're trying to win or something and that's not fun for everyone. So for me, it's like, it's really about saying, hey, I'm going to try something here. We don't have to use it. Is it okay? You feel good about that? And then with Dwayne, it's always yes. And with Gal, it's always yes. And and they do it as well. And you know, really, at the end of the day, this is just a bunch of friends working together. We've all known each other forever. So what we have off screen is very similar to what we have on screen.
Well, thank you so much, guys.
Thank you for the interview.
We both know that this whole thing is going to end with you in handcuffs.
Promises. Promises.